Hi friend, my name is Raza Masood. Today we will discuss about change control system. Friend, let me tell you that it's a very easy topic to understand and you can need some only few minutes to understand the concept of change control system. So first of all, I would request to just subscribe to my channel and click on the bell option. So let's start. What is basically a change control system? Friend, basically it's a term related to project management. And normally use it in whenever we talk about the project management methodologies. So this term norm pertains to project management. Before going into deep for change control system, first try to understand the concept of change. What is basically a change? Friend, change is basically thing like just consider that you have started a project as a project manager and the scope document which defines the overall scope of a project is already signed. So a scope of work is already signed. According to the scope of work, you have to deliver 5 modules. Let's assume that you have to deliver 5 modules for a mobile app to customer. After 1 month, customer came to you and he said that he needs one more module in the scope. So you have to implement that change in the system. Okay, so it needs some time, some effort, and it has some impact on the time, schedule, cost and scope. So as a project manager, you have to evaluate all these things. So this is called, in simple words, this is called a change. Change means that things which are already signed, for example, the scope of work was signed. Now changes are coming in the scope of a project. So we have to implement that. If that change is signed, so we have to implement that change in the project if it's approved. So this was the main concept of a change. Now coming towards the topic change control system. Change control system means that how changes will be implemented at production. Production means that how it will be delivered to customer, how it will deliver to client at production, at which the real user will start using the system. So change control system basically is a system that serves the essential purpose of assuring that the process of making changes is not done arbitrarily and without any thought, but rather is carefully considered and ultimately signed off on by a responsible party. What does that mean? Let me tell you. For example, you have already implemented 5 modules at production and customer of your mobile app is already using 5 modules at production. Now one more module came and this change was approved. Now try to understand that you are implementing that change at production. So it is not like that this is not possible that you just implement that one more module at production. This will not be possible. So there should be some mechanism, there should be some procedure to implement that change at production. So because implementation of customer at production means that customer will start using it, so you need some procedure, some mechanism through which that change will goes at production system. That means some authorities, some sign-offs will be required. So once the authorities approve that this change is okay, this is properly, the QA quality assurance is okay, it is properly tested, it is properly verified by the user. So after all these verifications, we will implement that changes at production. So change control system basically ensures that any change which is going at production will require proper sign-offs, approvals from the authorities, and it's all the required necessary testings and verifications are done before it's going on to the production, before it is handing over to customer. So this is basically called as concept of change control system, that how you are moving a change at production. Production means delivery to customer at which the real user, the real users of the customer of the app, for example, any system, will start using it. Okay, for example, let me tell you, let's suppose you are already using a mobile app of attendance system. Okay, and now one more feature is coming in the attendance system. So before adding that feature at production, you need proper sign off from the authorities, proper testing. Once you have all these things, then you can implement that change at the production. If you don't have the all these things like approvals and testing, you can't implement that change at production. Okay, so this is called as the concept of change control system. Change, if you just see the definition, the term change control system means a mechanism to handle, to control, to manage a change. Okay, just remember this term, change control system, mechanism to manage or handle the change. Now, what are the basically elements of change control system? Friend, change control system has mainly a mechanism, a decision body who can approve, who can reject or postpone any changes. And also, but it is not limited to only these things like only approval or rejection, but it also defines the process which will be utilized. Okay, first of all, try to understand that change control system basically defines a body, a mechanism through which a change which is going at production, which you want to implement at production, it can be approved, reject or postponed by the decision body. Decision body means senior management or your main stakeholder from your side, I mean from your vendor side, the owner of production system, the IT administration, these main stakeholder are basically responsible, are basically the decision body or decision maker who can check the change, who can verify the change, and they can give go ahead or decline your change. Okay, so these persons are basically called as the change control body or decision maker for change implementation. For example, let me tell you, like for example, change control process can include the change control policy, the change control board. Change control board means, or simply CCB, is basically a combination of senior management, IT administration, network administration, quality assurance persons. So not quality assurance person, only the senior management basically includes in the change control board. And the change control, change management system, for example, Jira, Bitbucket, these sorts of softwares, and quality assurance team separately. So all these types of persons of personnel can include in the change control process, who basically, let me tell you that, for example, one change you are going to implement at production. This change is basically implemented by a developer. The quality assurance person QA the change and give a report that this procedure is okay, this change is okay. Then it's verified by the user through UAT. Then it will be presented to a change control board who includes the senior management, the network administration, the project management team, etc. And also this will be the change control board, and also QA report or QA person, user acceptance report, and the project management tool, the change control management, change management tool like Jira report or Bitbucket report. So all these types of documents are basically presented to change control board and requested for the approval to implement that change at the production. Are you getting my point? Like all the persons, for example, senior management, QA person, the project management, IT administration, basically all these persons will sit together and a report, a request from project management will be presented to all these persons, which include the change control board, and request for the implementation of that change as production. And this these persons will include the senior management, IT administration, project management, QA person, and it requires the report of QA, user acceptance report, and the change control tool like Jira report or Bitbucket report. So all these things, these are the process in which project management presented that report to change control board that this change needs to be implemented in production. And change control board has full authority if they found any gap, any problem in the implementation. Like for example, QA report says that this change is not okay, or user acceptance report is saying that this change is not okay. So change control board or CCB has full authority to reject the change or postpone the change, or if all the things are okay, they can give go ahead to implementation at production. So this is called the whole procedure. Also remember one thing, the change control system should be able to handle any emergency changes or ad hoc changes. Every company has some procedures. So remember one thing, one change is planned change. Like for example, you are implementing a mobile app and adding one more new feature in the mobile app. So it's a planned change. So all things are planned. However, there could be one possibility that you are implementing any change which is not planned, which is basically on ad hoc basis or emergency basis. For example, one issue occurred at your production system. For example, the core banking system having some problem, which is a severity level 1 issue, and you must have to solve it on very urgent basis. So basically it is an emergency change or ad hoc change. So remember one thing, the change control system should define the separate procedure to handle these emergency changes or ad hoc basis changes. Remember one thing, the procedure could not be same for planned changes and ad hoc changes. The procedure or change control system for planned changes should be different, and the procedure of change control system for ad hoc emergency changes should be different. Why? Because the time slot or the factor of time is totally different for if you talk about the changes in ad hoc basis or at emergency basis. Definitely you have to do many things at production on very very urgent time, and you don't have enough time to do the things. However, but definitely whatever the change we are doing at emergency level at production, but it will definitely require some sort of procedure, some sort of mechanism to handle the things, and some sort of approvals as well. However, the procedure of change control system at emergency level should be properly documented and well communicated, and very quick basis it should be handled. So friend, that's all from my side. I hope you like this video. I have tried my level best to explain the concept of change control system. If you have any question, please do ask from me. I would love to answer your queries. And also I would request to please subscribe to my channel. If you like this video, please share it with your friends and colleagues, and also like my video. I would be very thankful to you. Thanks a lot for your time, and that's all from my side.